Quantad. Where's my briefcase?
You go and look for your briefcase, son. Where is he?
He's always late.
What is that?
What, hello, Bean?
Oh,
how
God,
you?
Look at
hello,
you.
Hello, Bobby.
What is this?
What do you reckon?
You look like Lord Toffingham.
Yes?
Yeah.
That's my goal, Lord Toffingham.
What are you trying to achieve, Paul?
Well, just a bit of fun, you know, trying to turn the clock back a bit.
Yeah, you're trying to look young, aren't you?
Well, yeah, you know, liven things up a little bit. Borrowed that off a friend.
Yeah.
Hello, Ted.
Did you know Ted might be having a little romantic date on this trip? Ted, what was your ideal lady?
Anyone with a briefcase.
You better get your waders on, Paul. We're going in.
Do that again. Ted did a weird leg movement. Look, there he goes. He's away.
That's called the dance of the briefcase. You'll find it one day, Ted.
Yeah.
Come on, let's fish.
You know where we are here?
The Longford estate?
Yeah, on the Hampshire Avon. Up there with the Wye, I think, probably is the best mixed fishery in the land.
Mixed, you're talking roach, chub?
Barbel, salmon, trout, good river carp, pike. But this is like the spiritual home of trotting for roach, really. We'll just wade out to there. It's not, I don't know what this bit is like here, but, and then we'll trot that little sort of run down there.
Yeah. I see.
Well, you see, it's slightly darker. Well, you can see the bottom there, look. Okay.
Can I hold your hand?
I think we should link
up. Well, it's just if you're going, I'm going.
Yeah, exactly. This is how they fish in Iceland, you know. They wade out like this.
Oh, he's in. He's kind of in. You all right?
He's in, he's out.
Oh, it grabs you, doesn't it?
It does, yeah. It's a chalk stream, really, the Avon.
Is it?
Yeah. Look, you can see the sort of gravel chalk bed.
Oh, wow, it's one of these super clean ones.
Yeah, yeah.
Good luck, Paul. So let's say target one, the roach.
Yes. That's it.
Yeah.
Not very fast flow here, is it?
My life's on a slow flow. This is a slow flow, isn't it?
It is.
I've gone slow flow. Just climb those stairs half pace. Maybe a rest on the landing.
Yeah.
Enter the bed, sit on the bed.
Oh, right, and then
spiral.
Sort of swing over or slide?
Sort of slide.
Yeah. When you forget to do those things and you sort of still think you're 34...
Yeah.
You get a timely warning, don't you?
My wife's often woken up in the night because I wake up...
And you go... To go
to the toilet, and my first step collapses under me, so I go down on the floor like a heap. I was trying to think, when you turned up in that flash car...
Yeah.
I'm trying to think, why would I feel so sickened? Because I did. And I thought, well, why?
Did you feel sickened by it?
Yeah.
Was
and then
that,
I realised, but it's not the car itself.
It's just the person driving
it. The combination
it.
Of that car with you.
Oh, I see, right.
So what would you say you're doing with the fancy club?
Ah, it's having a little bit of fun, Bob.
I don't see the fun of it.
What, having a swish car?
Yeah, look at me.
And a snazzy jacket?
Yeah. Driving along the A303 there. Don't look at me. Oh, no, don't look at me.
Morning! Yeah, you know.
If I'm in a room and everyone's just dressed normal, and then there'll always be someone who comes in, like, in a blue suit... that's too tight for them, and shiny sort of shoes and that. And that upsets me because I think about, you know, what's their motivation? They're not really confident enough of their personality to let their personality do the work.
I see. So a flamboyant dresser, according to you, doesn't have a personality.
There you go.
I know what you mean. Sometimes you think people... hyperdress, I call it.
Yeah.
To mask a sort of social inadequacy,
yeah.
Do you think?
That's what I like to say. Or maybe it's just I'm jealous of them because they look really good.
Exactly. There is that, isn't there?
You know, it could just be that.
No, they can carry it off and I couldn't. Bob, this is fairly fruitless.
It is at the moment.
So much so that I'm going to let you take over for a while.
OK. That just wasn't quite on top of things, Paul.
That is probably the best bite we've had all morning. Right. Look at this weed starting to detach, look. It's a bit scary, isn't it? It is, isn't it? Look, it's going.
It's like the sort of thing maybe Sylvester Stallone's underneath it, you know, floating under.
Look at it go, look. Can we knock this on the head?
Yeah, come on.
Right.
I'll get you a hot drink.
Yeah, nice.
I mean, if you're going to have a barren session, no nicer place than this.
No, that's true. I think it's good for the soul to, you know, like, not catch. I do, you know. Right, come on. Here we are.
Is it a mill?
Yeah.
Oh, I love flour. Oh, I couldn't do without it.
Really?
Sometimes I get up in the middle of the night, just check, have I got any flour? I'll tap the wife. Love. I'm so sorry. I know it's 3 o'clock in the morning. We have got self-raising flour, haven't we, downstairs? She said, yes. Oh. Yes, 40 bags.
What is it with you and the self-raising flour?
Nice cuppa.
Lovely. Is it nice?
Yeah.
What is that?
It's green tea.
Well, hold up, mate. Wait a minute, son. Say that again.
It's green tea.
Oh, it's green tea, is it?
Yeah.
Yeah, you thought I was gonna do a big charade about, well, I ain't drinking that much. I want English breakfast tea and that builder's tea. But no, yeah. It's
I green want tea. Yorkshire tea.
Yorkshire.
Grown on Pennines.
Right.
So this has got polyphenols in it.
It's very good for you, green tea, isn't it?
It's great for you. Basically, all inflammation.
Like a little kangaroo. Yeah. Like a tiny kangaroo.
Yeah, it's like a bunny disease, isn't it? Yeah. Just as you're talking, you go, bunny! It's anti-inflammatory. All over your bunny! All over your... all over your body.
Fair play. Cheers, Bob.
Right, let's get a roach.
Thank you, Robert.
That was vigorous.
Be careful as you go out there, Bob. If you could put some maggots in for me... Yeah, that's good.
Little secret, little pool.
Isn't it?
Off the beaten track.
I'm just going to try.
That I like it.
You like it?
This is beautiful, clear water, isn't it?
It is, isn't it?
Sunshine on an autumn day, Paul. You can't beat it.
No.
I think there was a survey and the majority of people said this is their favourite weather.
It's a cracker, isn't it? God, look at it up there, Bob, as well, look.
Everything's dying.
Yeah, but it's living. All right, Ted, we don't need your help, mate.
Big day for Ted tomorrow.
Don't build it up, son.
All right, sorry. No, you're right.
You know what I'm saying? Because I'll go to pieces.
That a bite, you
know? Ooh, straight in.
Look, that's a roach, yeah.
Whoa. Well done.
Quite a nice one.
Do you think I'll leave the net, Paul?
I think it's a roach, isn't it? Yep.
Whoa, not bad at all.
Look at that. Look.
Well done.
Hey, that's a nice roach, look.
Let's have a look at him.
Hey, look at that.
They're such a pretty fish, aren't they?
Yeah.
And that beautiful eye.
Yeah, it's lovely, isn't it?
Yeah.
Right, should we get him back?
We should get him back, yeah.
Yeah.
And away!
There we go.
What a beautiful fish, Paul.
Oh, gorgeous, isn't it?
The accommodation beckons.
Yeah.
Can I come with you in the sports car?
Well, you can, but I mean...
We're fishing here tomorrow, so I could leave my car here.
It's very clean in my car.
So you're saying I'm filthy? I'm not filthy,
no,
look
just...
at me.
Come Put out. Your hands on the bonnet, sir. Put your hands on the bonnet. Are you carrying any car meat?
No, of course.
Hands on the bonnet!
Sorry.
All right, empty your pockets.
Look, Paul.
Who's Paul? You got an accomplice? You work as a team, do you?
Oh.
What's in your pockets?
Can I take my hands off the bonnet, officer?
Yes.
Dark glasses.
Dark glasses?
Yeah.
Sorry, oh, I went out of character there. Dark glasses!
Oh, you've got a softer side, officer, haven't you?
Good cop, bad cop. Oh.
It's just 6 lucky sweets.
6 lucky sweets? Is that what you call them?
OK, so that's it, officer. That's all I've got.
Well, there's another pocket. You haven't emptied that pocket.
There's nothing in there.
Empty the pocket.
Honestly, there's nothing
in there. Empty the pocket. That's nothing, is it?
It's just a hanky.
Let's open it up, gently.
There's nothing in there.
There's something in there, I can see it. Oh, you dirty...
It's pocket chicken bites.
I can see what it is. They're not going in my car, mate, so you're going to have to dispose of them, aren't you?
Are you insisting on that, officer?
Eat it. And a licorice also. Go on, and a licorice also.
Don't do that to me.
Paul! Scaring old men. I see people like you every day in a yellow Porsche or a...
Oh, it's all wrong, Bob.
Well, when your friend said borrow it, why did you borrow it?
Just for a bit of fun.
And justify your tweed jacket to me?
Again, I'm having a bit of a laugh, mate.
What? A tweed jacket's not fun.
Nearly there, Paul.
See some lights through the trees.
Oh, I can see a bit of light. That must be the accommodation.
It is, Paul.
Oh! Ooh.
And there you go. It's a beauty!
Oh, isn't it? Look at that.
Let's get in.
Lovely. Sort of very modern log cabin, isn't it? Oh, I like this.
This is a nice room.
Hey, I like it.
But, Paul, what bedrooms await me and thee?
No!
Bedroom? Oh, Paul.
What?
Oh, sorry, it's 2 bunk beds.
Oh, right, yeah. That's a shame, isn't it? Because you thought this was a wall, didn't you?
What for you?
Let's have a little look.
Oh, man.
Oh, yes. You have the bunkular beds, but look what I have found. The presidential suite.
Oh, Paul, can I have it?
No.
If you're having that room, Paul, then you can cook our dinner.
I can cook, yeah.
So what are you cooking? A couple of onions?
Yeah, just gonna boil 2 onions, Bob, for you. Would you like that?
That's a great meal, isn't it? So what are you doing? You're cooking me onions? Tell me, what's your dish?
It's a little surprise.
I'll tell you what the surprise is gonna be.
Yeah?
It's inedible.
Are you just gonna stand there and make facetious remarks?
Do you know what, Paul? I'm gonna leave you be, I think, and I'm gonna I'll go and have a bath.
Well, you're not gonna... What?
I'm gonna have a bath.
Would you like,
a pudding, yeah. He's not got pudding on the menu. All right.
Yes, it's coming along nicely, Bob. Just simmering. What about you? Are you simmering?
Yeah, just having a nice bath.
How's that coming along?
Pretty good.
Yeah?
Pretty sexy.
Oh, my God. Look at you, little tiny... man in a great big bath.
Well, I'm parboiling at the moment, so...
Yeah.
Shall I get out? Is it you ready?
Give it... You can have a couple of minutes, all right?
Thank you.
Oh, yeah. Really, but what a pleasant little vista this is.
God.
Right. Look what I've got here, look.
Ooh, hello. Bob. Essence of Bob.
Essence of Bob.
Bob's cheese.
I want Bob's, exactly, Bob's cheese. Be careful now, it's very hot. So this is a high-protein casserole with lean turkey mince and tortilla on top. I mean, I wouldn't go as far as to say it's heart-healthy, but it's heart-warming.
It ain't bad. Turkey mince,
turkey
a
mince,
bit of cheese.
Kidney bean.
I was told I'm allowed a matchbox-size amount of
cheese
a week, so...
A week?
Well, a month, but, you know.
I knew you'd exaggerated that. Well, it looks all right, doesn't it?
Looks all right.
What do you reckon?
Sweet as a nut.
Is it really?
Beautiful.
Are you just saying that?
No.
OK. Here, Bob, what are we doing tomorrow?
We're going back to the Avon.
Yep.
And it's so bountiful, we're just going to see what we can get.
Yeah.
Cheers.
Cheers, Bob. What are you doing, Bob?
I'm cutting some North London bread.
North
you don't have an axe, do you?
It's lovely out here, Bob. It's a pastoral scene, obviously.
Yeah. There you go. Super healthy breakfast. That's all you need. What's the look for?
Are you having a bubble bath?
What, was I wearing grapefruit?
I can't eat them. Forbidden.
No, you must eat them. Paul, heart health-wise... Potassium, daily supply of vitamin C, gets your blood pressure down, gets rid of cholesterol, tuck in.
I can't eat them. I know that they're brilliant, aren't they? They're fantastic. But I'm not allowed to eat them because I'm on massive statins. So there you go. There's a bit of heart info for you, Bob.
I've really let you down.
You haven't let me down. You've tried really hard. Don't put sugar on it. Don't ruin it.
Oh, come on, they're inedible without it.
Stop.
It's a lovely day for fishing.
It's not bad. It's a bit nippy.
Bit nippy. I like it.
Do you? You like that? It makes you feel a bit vital. Probably makes you feel a bit younger, does it, Bob?
Yeah. It makes me feel younger than you look in your poxy jacket.
Hey!
Hey, yeah, 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 yeah.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah, yeah.
Do you want a feel of it?
It's very
tailored, don't you think?
I mean, it's age appropriate, Paul. I like that. Because they say for older people, number one rule is don't try and dress like a young person.
Well, like you have.
I dress for comfort.
No, you surprise me.
Let us not forget, Paul, that today is... I've arranged this date for Ted. Well, we should give him a little talking to before we leave.
Yeah, we should.
Oh, he's not gone out, has he?
Ted? Oh, here he is. Look, Bob. Ted.
Oh, he's dressed up for his date.
Oh, you've made an effort, haven't you, Ted, mate?
Ted, I don't really like your top. Ted.
Do me a favour. That is a statement of fashion, that is. Oh.
It's a little bit like an old fella trying to look young, Paul.
I suppose it is straining a bit here, isn't it? I'll put on a couple of pounds, don't I?
Now, Ted, anyway. I'll be the young lady you meet. She's called Effie, right? Hello, my name's Effie. What's your name?
My name is Edward. Or Ted. Well, Teddy Bobby.
That is very good. What are your interests, Ted?
Romantic poetry, explosives, fashion, as you can see.
Yeah. Mm. I'll play down the explosive side of things a bit.
OK, well, keep that one for a bit later.
Forget it completely.
All right.
So, Ted, I'm interested in briefcases. Do you like briefcases?
You're joking me.
No, I love briefcases, but so sad I lost my favourite briefcase recently.
No, that happened to me, no.
That's good, Ted.
Yeah.
Good luck, Ted.
Yeah, good luck, Ted. Good
maybe
luck.
Maybe not the shirt, though, Ted.
Yeah, let's lose the shirt, mate.
I'm going to try a worm pull.
OK, mate.
Thank you. Ooh, big bird. What's that? A heron?
Yeah. Ooh, right, come on, Bob. Get ready. Get ready, get ready. Go on, let it go. Yep. Yeah. You got one or not?
I've got a bite now.
The fish that you took has taken my line. Bob, you got a good fish.
And yeah, it's quite a good fish.
This is a comedy of errors. Don't whine!
I'm not...
Let your line out, let your line out.
All right.
Lift your rod up.
I've got a good fish on here, Paul.
I know you have, and I'm caught on your line. Let some line out, Bob! Right, like, gently, gently, please, Bob. I think it might be a roach, and it might be a nice roach.
It's a good fish, Paul.
Yeah. Is it a chub? It's a nice chub, I think you've got there. Yes! Hey!
Wow! Look at that, Paul!
Whoa, Bob, well done, mate!
Look, Paul!
Wow!
A River Avon chub, look at his bronze!
Beauty, look at the neck of him, look.
Bit of blue on the tail. Oh!
Well, cool. Right, let's get him back.
Let's get him back.
There we go, look.
Whee. And away.
And away.
Oh, wow!
Superb angling there, Bob.
Oh, man.
I got a bit grumpy with you there, didn't I? I'm sorry about that, Bob, but...
But that's part of the excitement, the panic of it. Paul, can we fish on? See what happens?
Yeah, of course.
Thank you, though, for your help.
That's a nice line through there, isn't it?
I want you like a coiled spring.
I'm turning round, look. I'm really not facing the right way.
Something's looking at it, something's looking at it. Keep your eyes peeled. Keep your buttocks tight.
Yep. Ooh, this is a bit bigger.
Well, that was very good fishing.
I don't know what it is. I can't see it. It's a nice fish, whatever it is.
Isn't it?
Can you see
this? Could
it
be
is?
Something.
Ooh. Big roach.
Huge.
Ooh. Oh!
You lost him. Sorry, I mean, he's gone. If it was a roach, it was massive.
Yeah. Oh.
I mean, the problem I'm having, Paul, is I think we just lost maybe the best fish that Gone Fishing has ever seen.
I think you might be right.
No, honestly, if that was a roach, Paul, that was, wow, I feel for you, man. You might have lost a fish of a lifetime.
Oh. Come on, Bobby. There's no stopping us, is there? This is a carrier of the main river, right?
Right.
And in here, there's a good head of river carp, right? I'm told.
Right.
And they patrol up and down, and we're going to try and intercept them. We might catch something, we might not. You might hook a big one and lose it.
So no float or anything?
No, I'm just going to tighten up now.
And now we wait.
Now we wait. This is a bit casual, isn't it? What do you think? Is it too casual?
Why didn't you wear your tweed jacket for this fishing?
Because I'm fishing now.
And what's the tweed jacket for when you're birding?
No, it's apres fishing.
Oh, apres fish.
Have you heard of this thing, Bob, called death cleaning?
Where they clean corpses where people have been murdered?
No. You sort out certain elements of your life that you no longer use and get rid of them. So that by the time you die, you're just a pure spirit. You know, you haven't left any old mess and rubbish behind for other people to clear up. And accumulate so much rubbish and stuff.
Yeah, but it's hard to throw it out. What with the, little memories or... Especially your kids' stuff, old
drawings. Well, I know, when you go to do it, it's very difficult.
It is difficult.
Yeah.
But I do see that it's, like leaving all that behind for other people to clean up and deal with.
Yeah.
One, it's sad, one, it's a pain. But too, it's quite sad for them, isn't it?
Very sad for them, isn't it? They come across an old toy that you haven't thrown out, it's going to stir all sorts of memories. Look at those leaves, man. Sort of lattice. Look. The way they've kind of corrupted. Amazing.
Nature's embroidery, isn't it?
It's actually really beautiful.
Whoa. Right, Ted, your date's here, yeah?
You're joking. Teddy! Teddy!
Remember what we told you, Ted?
Yes, do as you're told now, Ted. Come on.
Don't just go on about briefcases all the time, yeah? Okay. And mind your language. Off you go.
Go on, go.
Good luck, Ted.
Go and get out.
Go on, Ted. Oh, well, we'll get out of the way.
All right.
Not cramping
stuff. Yeah, come on in. God, she's legging it. Ted, what did he say?
We'll never know, Paul. Come on, let's have a word with him.
Ted, what did you say to her?
Were you swearing, Ted?
Blimey, there's nothing big or clever about it, Ted.
Nah, never mind, I.
Ted, what are you doing?
Oh, Ted, he needs a little bit of comfort.
Here, have one of these biscuits. I think he might be more upset than he's letting on, you know.
No, what are you talking about? No. Nothing wrong with me.
Never mind, Ted.
No. Look, it's just water under the bridge. We didn't have nothing in common. We didn't click, you know?
Oh, well, you're taking it very well. Hey, Ted, remember, you have always got us two.
That's right, Ted. Yeah. You got us.
You
he
got
don't
it.
Need her.
Hmm? Where's my briefcase?
Where's my briefcase?
Do you know what, Ted? I think we might go shopping for a briefcase. What do you reckon to that?
A leather one?
Yeah, you can have leather.
Burgundy leather?
Yeah.
There's nothing I like better.
In one single moment, your whole life can turn round. I stand there for a minute, staring straight into the ground. Looking to the left slightly, then looking back down. World feels like it's caved in, proper sorry frown.
Dry your eyes, mate. I know it's hard to take, but her mind has been made up. There's plenty more fish in the sea. Dry your eyes, mate. I know you want to make her see how much this pain hurts. But you've got to walk away now. Over.
So then I move my hand up from down by my side, shaking, my life is crashing before my eyes.